In the next 10 minutes, I want to talk about
Good afternoon, everybody. In the next 10 minutes, I want to talk about the study we made on performance development and career progression of world-class Olympic distance triathletes. And the question is why we did that. So, there is, as far as we know, there is little known how successful triathletes develop. Last year, we made a study on career development of top 10 triathletes in World Junior Championships from 2002 to 2006. And we saw that the top 5 ranked juniors have a chance of establishment of 36%. Here we are. Of 36%, and the 6 to 10 ranked athletes in the Junior World Championships have a significant lower chance. So, therefore, top 5 ranking in junior world championships might be a predictor for future establishment in the elite triathlon. We also have some means of success, at least we have in Switzerland. When we talk to coaches, they say, stay tuned, it's rewarded. That means also after years in the midfield, there are chances to achieve the top 10 ranking in world-class races. They also say it's never too late. That means also late entrants can be successful in triathlon. And they also say that only the ones successful as juniors achieve good ranking in elite races. So the key questions in this study we have is there a typical course of development for world-class triathletes? And are there predictors and managers triathlon? And the objective we have is to identify scientifically based advice on how career development in triathlon can be made effective. So therefore, we analyzed the development patterns of the top 20 men and women of the 2009 IQ World Ranking based on the result list of the Junior World Championships and the World Cup or World Championship Series. It was noted when athletes appeared for the first time in the Junior World Championships and when the entry and first top 10 ranking in the World Cup or World Championship Series was. So, let's look at the results. If we look at age and ranking, first appearance in the World Cup or World Championship Series with the men, we see three groups. We have 7 of these top 20 athletes which did not attend the Junior World Championship. Most of them, we call them career changers. They come mainly from swimming and running, and they have an average of 21.6 years when they did their first World Cup race. 5 of them, 20 athletes attended Junior World Championships but had not achieved any top 10 ranking. So they were 21.0 years old. And 8 of the top 20 athletes achieved top 10 rankings already as juniors, and they have an average of 20.6 years. So the average of these three groups are practically the same. They are around 21 years, but what you can see is that the group of athletes which had success at Junior World Championship is a much narrower group. That means the window of entry in the World Championship and in the World Cup is much, much smaller than a year, around smaller than the other two groups. If you look at the first top 10 results of the men, we see that athletes who participated at Junior World Championships are by trend earlier successful for those who attend to a junior world championship, they have an average of 1 year, 1 year from the first World Cup to the first attendance result. We also see that the athletes which didn't attend the world world junior championships, they had almost 2 years, just 1 year more than those who have a longer career in triathlon. It does not matter, it doesn't take longer than 5 years until an athlete is successful. We see that also with the examples of David Klaus, Julian Malyshev, and Simon Whitfield is 4 years. Do we see the same at the women's field? The age at the first appearance in the World Cup, we see 7 of the top 20 athletes from the women did not attend junior world championships. We call them also career changes. They have an average of 23.9 years. That means women are much older in average to compare to these male career changes. 4 of the top 20 athletes attended junior world championships but have not achieved any top 10 rankings as juniors. They have an average of 20.8 years. And 9 of the top 20 athletes achieving top 10 rankings more as junior, they have also 20.6 years as an average. So the age of participants entering world championships are practically the same, except those who come across from other sports. The last athletes are getting in at 23 years. If we look at the results, we see that athletes who participate at junior world championships are by trend early successful, 21.7 and 22.3 years, but also career changes achieve success with an average of 24.1 years. And that's the astonishing thing. Besides, you see that the oldest female having success the first time was 28 years. The very interesting thing is that career changes, they don't even have a year until they establish in the world. In comparison with those attending to junior world championships, which have about the same average of 1.2 years. So we come to the discussion and conclusions. So athletes can establish themselves in the World Cup or World Championship Series even without the top 10 result at junior World Championships. We also see that top 20 World Cup athletes reach success, that means top 10 results, very quickly, much quicker than we thought after entering the World Cup or World Championship Series. The maximum period of time is 5 years. Athletes without junior world championship participation tend to appear later, that's clear. They tend to appear later in the World Cup, especially women. An athlete should be in the world elite within 25, 26 years of age, except one female which entered the